أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
Today we'll be starting with Surah Az-Zumar. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز الحكيم. إنا أنزلنا إليك الكتاب بالحق فاعبد الله مخلصا له الدين ألا لله الدين الخالص. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. اللهم ربنا ألهمنا رشدنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. آمين يا رب العالمين. I have already told you that these two groups of Makki surahs, the eight from Surah Al-Furqan to Surah Al-Sajda, eight surahs, and then from these 13 surahs, starting from Surah Al-Saba, and it will come to an end on Surah Al-Ahqaf in 26th part. They want to make 21 surahs. And the central theme of these surahs is Tawheed. Although, along with Tawheed, other articles of faith, that is resurrection, the life of hereafter, the Jannah and Jahannam, the hell, and the Garden of Eden, etc., etc. These things are also discussed. Along with the institution of prophethood, Nabuwah, Risala. But the main is, the focus is on Tawheed. And out of these, mostly the surahs are discussing the Tawheed of creed, Tawheed fil Aqeedah, theoretical Tawheed. That is, we believe in Allah is one. Nobody is equal to Him. He doesn't have any associates or partners or rivals or equals, neither in His person nor in attributes. He begot none and not was begotten Himself. All these things are theoretical about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are no associates. Nobody can intercede on any behalf of any person without His permission. So all these things are, they belong to our creed, our aqeedah. You may call it dogma. Or, as I'm saying, it's the theoretical aspect of Tawheed. Now the other aspect of Tawheed is practical Tawheed. To worship Allah and Allah alone. To obey Him, absolute obedience to Him only. All other obediences will be subject to His approval. We can obey our parents, we can obey our elders, we can obey our teachers, we can obey our rulers, provided their obedience doesn't mean a disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If the elders, the rulers, the parents, the husband to the wife, as they say, don't do this, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared it to be obligatory, you have to disobey. And if you don't disobey them, it means you are disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is shirk. Now, you have accepted them as superior to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are accepting their command and rejecting the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, this is haram, this is haram. But maybe your parents pressurize you, do it. But now if you bow at the pressure of the parents. What does that mean? You have disobeyed Allah. So there is a very good saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. There can be no obedience to anyone who is created. All are created. Parents are created. Saints are created. Prophets are created. Everybody. في معصية الخالق. If, you know, the command of the parents is not against them, okay, obey them, no harm. If the command of the rulers is not against the deen of Allah, not against the command of Allah, okay, obey them, no harm. But when they collide with each other, then you have to cling to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and disobey every other person, whosoever he might be. This is tawheed. Now this is the practical aspect of tawheed. And I have discussed only at the individual level, this practical aspect. This practical tawheed now rises to the level of the state. At the level of the state, if you declare, here is sovereignty of Allah, everything is under His sovereignty, this is tawheed. And if you accept sovereignty of someone else, he might be anyone. One individual, as it is in the monarchy, or the sovereignty belongs to the people, to the whole masses, common people. It doesn't make any difference. It is shirk in both ways. Because sovereignty belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you accept the sovereignty of Allah, and under the sovereignty of Allah, within the Sharia and commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you establish a system, social system, political system. This is called the system of caliphate, khilafa. What's the difference? There was Namrud who said, I am the Lord, I am God. He argued with Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. We have read it in Surah Al-Baqarah. Then there were Pharaohs. They used to say, Alayhi salim ulku Misr, I am the monarch of Misr. This Egypt is under me and the whole irrigation system is controlled by me. On the other hand, Dawood, he said, oh, I am a bondsman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I myself am a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I only rule you according to the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Apparently, he was also a king, but he was not a king. He was a caliph. Last night we read the ayah. Ya Dawood, inna ja'alnaka khalifatan fil ard. Not sovereign, not king. Who was Solomon? Sulaiman alayhi salam, a caliph. What was Muhammad in Medina sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after Hijrah? It was a government, no doubt. Who was the ruler? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But he was a caliph, not sovereign. He was himself a bondsman of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we say in that our kalma shahadat, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. First he is a bondsman and servant of Allah, and then he is the messenger of Allah. This position of messenger of Allah is secondary. The primary position is, he is the abd of Allah. As I have pointed out many a times, the three surahs, very important surahs, in the opening ayats of all these surahs, you find this position of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as abd. It is highlighted. Subhanallazi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa. Alhamdulillahillazi anzala ala 'abdihi al-kitaba wa lam yaj'al lahu iwaja. Tabarakallazi nazzala al-furqana ala 'abdihi liyakuna lil-'alamin nazira. This position, he is the abd. This is superior to his position that he is a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Actually, this is the practical aspect of Tawheed, which are unfortunately, even those, you know, groups among the Muslim Ummah, who attach maximum importance to Tawheed, and they think about themselves, they are the Mawahideen, even they don't know this aspect. if you don't accept sovereignty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, theoretically you are believing He is one, nobody is equal to Him, nobody will be able to intercede before Him for anybody except with His permission. All these things, these are theoretical aspects of Tawheed. The practical aspect of Tawheed is Ibadah. But this Ibadah has to be exclusively for Him. Yesterday in my Jummah sermon here in this very center, I discussed this subject, Ibadah. And today I want to repeat briefly. Quran says that all the jinns and human beings were created to do Ibadah towards Allah. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ All the messengers called the people to Ibadah. إِنَّا أَرْسَلْنَا نُوحًا إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ أَنَنْزِرْ قَوْمَكَ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَيَّاتِهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ اعْبُدُوا اللَّهَ مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ غَيْرُ And the call of Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ اتَّقُوا اعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Now, what is this ibadah? Number one, total obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Absolute obedience for Him only. All the other obediences will be conditional to the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'll accept whatever you command me, provided you don't give me any order which is repugnant to the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His obedience has to be higher up. So this is actually the meaning of ibadah. But this obedience should be based on a deep love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The body of ibadah is made of obedience. But the spirit of ibadah is love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ And about this love also, you can love your spouses, you can love your children, you can love your parents, you can love your country. But love of Allah should remain supreme over all these loves. If it is so, then you are a muwahid, Unitarian. But if love of one single thing or person is more than the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now you are a mushrik. All loves, all affections to be within and below the love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ Ayah number 24 of Surah At-Tawbah. Tell them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O people, if your fathers, your sons, your brothers, your wives, or your spouses, or your relatives, or the wealth that you have accumulated, or the business for which you keep fearing lest there should be some recession, and the houses you have built and they are very dear to you, if the love for these eight things is more in your hearts than the love of Allah and love of Muhammad and the love for jihad in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then go and wait there till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala issues His final command, gives His final judgment. And Allah is not going to guide such transgressors. Your love has to be more than anything before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger. This is Tawheed. But if something is more dear to you than Allah, now for example, if wealth, money is more dear, you are ready to grab it, although it is coming through haram means, forbidden means. What does it mean? Love for this money is more than the love for Allah. So this money has become your ma'bud. And there is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, ta'isa abdud dinar wa abdud dirham. Woe to the person who is abd of dinar and dirham. His name is Abdul Rahman or Abdullah. But actually, he is abd of dinar and abd of dirham. Dirham and dinar is more important to him, more dear to him than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the hadith. Ta'is abdul dinar wa abdul dirham. So this practical aspect of Tawheed is discussed, especially in the coming four surahs. Surah Az-Zumar, Surah Al-Mumin, Surah Hamim As-Sajda, and finally Surah Ash-Shura. Now we begin with Surah Az-Zumar. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Tanzeel al-Kitab min Allah al-Aziz al-Hakim. Descending down of this book is from Allah, who is Almighty and All-Wise. Inna anzalna ilayka al-kitaba bil-haq. We have sent down this book to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, with truth, total truth. Fa'budillaha. So worship Allah, obey Allah, love Allah. Now for worship, I'll be adding these two words. Obedience to Allah, love of Allah. Actually, they go to make ibadah. Otherwise, only worship, you know. You are praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but you are not obeying Him. It is, you are saying something else and doing something else. In the prayer, you say, Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. But actually, you are not doing so. You are telling a lie. If you are not obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you say, Iyaka na'budu, you are telling a lie. What gain will you have from this prayer? Unless what you say and what you do, they are harmonized. They are the same. فَعْبُدِ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصَ اللَّهُ الدِّينَ. Now this is the term specially. To keep your obedience exclusively for Allah. I have told you. It doesn't say that don't obey your parents. You can obey your parents. Provided. It doesn't mean disobedience to Allah. You can obey your elders, your rulers, whosoever they are. But provided, it doesn't entail a disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, absolute obedience is exclusively reserved for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what is meant by these words, مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ. Deen means obedience. أَلَا لِلَّهِ الدِّينُ الْخَالِصِ. Behold, for Allah is the only pure deen. What does it mean? Allah accepts pure deen, khalis deen. No impurity. No impurity of disobedience. No impurity of accepting some other also for obedience, independent of the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the impurity. So, ala lillahi deenul khalis. Allah demands from you deen, where obedience, absolute obedience is exclusively reserved for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِهِ أَوْلِيَاءَ, as for those who have taken besides Allah other gods, other protectors, مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى, they say, we don't worship them, but only in order that they can take us nearer, nearer, nearer to Allah. Mushrik is the one who believes in the big Allah, the great Allah. But there are small Aliha, Mahadev and Devis and Devtas. God with capital G, one. Gods and goddesses with small g, innumerable. But these gods were taken as if they will make us nearer and nearer and nearer and nearer to that big God. مَا نَعْبُدُهُمْ إِلَّا لِيُقَرِّبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ زُلْفَى إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ فِي مَا هُمْ فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ. Verily Allah will judge between them on the day of judgment in all the matters in which they had been differing. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي مَنْ هُوَ كَاذِبٌ كَفَّارٌ. And verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't guide to the right path whosoever is a liar and ungrateful. لَوْ رَادَ اللَّهُ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا لَاسْتَفَى مِمَّا يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءَ. Had Allah wished to take a son to Himself, He could have chosen anybody from His creatures. Subhana. But He is above all this. He doesn't need a son. He is ever living Himself. You need sons. Why? Because you know you will die. Your name will continue through your lineage, your sons and then the grandsons. But Allah is ever living. He doesn't need a son. هو الله الواحد القهار هي ذا الله دي اونلي ون اینڈ دی اومنی پوٹینٹ خلق السماوات والارض بالحق ہی کریئیٹڈ دی ہیونز اینڈ دی ارتھ ود ٹروتھ ود پرپس یکور اللیل علی النہار ہی میکس دی نائٹ کور دی ڈے یکور النہار علی اللیل اینڈ دین ہی میکس دی ڈے کور دی نائٹ بسخر الشمس والقمر ہی ہیز سبجیکٹڈ فار یو دی سن اینڈ دی مون کل یجری لاجل المسمى آل آر رننگ on their own courses, their own orbits, for an appointed period of time. Ajalin Musamma. Ala huwa al-azizul ghaffar. Behold, he is the mighty and he is the forgiver. Khalaqakum min nafsin wahida. He created you out of one being. Summa ja'ala minha zawjaha. And from that being he created a spouse or a mate for it. وانزل لكم من الانعام ثمانية ازواج and he has sent down for you eight pairs, eight couples of cattle, mainly the, you know, there were the goats, the sheep, the cows and the camels. These were the four cattle which were there in Arabia. So mostly these are mentioned. Two in each, she camel, he camel, male and female, so they go to make eight. Samaniyat azwaj. Yakhluqukum fi butun ummahatikum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates you and makes you perfect in the wombs of your mothers. Khalqan ba'da khalqan. Creation after creation. فی ظلمات سلاس ان دی ڈارکنس آف دی تھری ویلز ہی از گیونگ یو شیپ اینڈ یو آر ان دی وومب آف یور مدر فرسٹ آف آل از دی ایبڈومینل وال آف دی مدر دین دیر از دی وال آف دی یوٹرس دین دیر از دی میمبرین ان وچ دی فیٹس از ریپڈ اپ تھری But within those three darknesses, Allah is shaping you. Allah is making you your eyes, your nose, your mouth, your ears. يَخْلُقُكُمْ فِي بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ خَلْقًا مِّن بَعْدِ خَلْقٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتٍ ثَلَاثٍ ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهُ رَبُّكُمْ He is Allah your Lord. لَهُ الْمُلْكُ To whom belongs this sovereignty? لا إله إلا هو There is no God except Him. فَأَنَّا تُصْرَفُونَ Where from are you being diverted? إِن تَكْفَرُوا And if you don't believe in him, فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ عَنْكُمْ So Allah doesn't need anything from you. He is free from all needs. He is absolutely sufficient. وَلَا يَرْضَى لِعِبَادِهِ الْكُفْرِ But he doesn't like this disbelief on behalf of his bondsmen and servants. فَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ And if you are grateful, he approves of it. وَلَا تَذَرُوا وَادِنَةٌ وِذْرَ أُخْرَى And no burdened soul will be able to carry these burdens of the others. ثُمَّ إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ مَرْجِعُكُمْ Then all of you will be returned to your Lord. فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ Then he will tell you what you had been doing. إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ Verily, he knows even that which is in your hearts and chests. وَإِذَا مَسَّ الْإِنسَانُ ضُرٌّ And when there is some affliction which comes to a man, human being, دَعَى رَبَّهُ مُنِيبًا إِلَيْهِ Now he calls upon his Lord, oh Allah, deliver me. You know, turning to him in repentance. ثُمَّ إِذَا خَوَّلَهُ نِعْمَةً مِّنْهُ Then when we have given him some blessing, that affliction goes, نَسِيَ مَا كَانَ يَدْعُوا إِلَيْهِ مِنْ قَبْلُ Now he just forgets what he has been calling upon us, what for. وَجَعَلَ لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا And then he declares rivals to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, equals to Allah. لِيُضُلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ So that he should lead people astray from his path. قُلْ تَمَتَّعْ بِكُفْرِكَ Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, you rejoice and enjoy along with your kufr. Allah is not taking your life at once. Allah is not punishing you at once. Okay, with your kufr you can enjoy. You live a while. إِنَّكَ مِنَ أَصْحَابِ النَّارِ. But finally, you are from among the dwellers of the fire. أَمَّنْ هُوَ قَانِتٌ عَنَا اللَّيْلِ سَاجِدًا. As for that who remains standing during the hours of night before his Lord, sajidan aw qaiman, sometimes standing, sometimes in prostration, yahzarul akhirah, he is fearful of the hereafter, wa yarju rahmatahu rabbihi, and he is hoping the mercy of his Lord. قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Ask them, can those people who know be equal to those who don't know? These are the people who know their Lord. These are the people who know that they have to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala one day. So now those who are absolutely heedless to these things, can they be equal? إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُوا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. Verily, admonition comes to only those people who understand. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to my bondsmen, O my servants who have come to believe in me, اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Have fear of your Lord. لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا. Whosoever does good deeds in this world, for him will be good reward. وَارْضُ اللَّهِ وَاسِعَ. And the land of Allah, earth of Allah, is very wide and vast. You can make hijra, you can immigrate. If at one place you cannot worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exclusively, leave that place. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّ الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Definitely, the truly persevering people will be paid their reward in full, beyond reckoning. قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ. Again, the same word is coming, مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ. This is the central theme of this surah. إِخْلَاص فِي الدِّينَ. Keeping the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala absolutely exclusive. Absolute obedience to Allah exclusively. Not associating anybody, anything along with the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينَ. Say, I have been commanded to worship and obey Allah, keeping my absolute obedience exclusive to Him. No obedience to anybody else, in which there comes some disobedience for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا تَعَاتَ لِمَخْلُوقٍ فِي مَعْصِيَةِ الْخَالِقِ. وَأُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَكُونَ أَوَّلَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And I have been commanded to become the first of those who submit themselves, surrender themselves to the will of God. قُلْ إِنِّي أَخَافُ إِنْ أَسَيْتُ رَبِّي عَذَابَ يَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. And say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even I fear the chastisement of a mighty day if I also disobey my Lord. I don't say I am above disobedience, above obedience. No, no. I am also an obedient servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Abdullah, I am Abd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qulillah a'budu mukhlisan lahu deeni. See, note it. This phrase is coming repeatedly. Twice in the very beginning and then twice here. Say, Qulillah a'budu mukhlisan lahu deeni. I worship and obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keeping my obedience, total obedience, exclusively for Him. Fa'budu ma shaytum. You worship and obey whomsoever you like, min dunihi, leaving him. قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Say, the real losers will be those who are losers on the day of judgment and who have their families also in loss. أَلَا ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. Behold, that is the manifest loss. لَهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ ذُلَلٌ مِنَ النَّارِ. For them there will be coverings from above of fire. وَمِنْ تَحَتِهِمْ ذُلَلٌ. And from beneath them also دی میٹریسز ول آلسو بی آف فائر. ذالک یخوف اللہ بہ عبادہ, دس از فار وچ اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی وانٹس ٹو فرائٹن ہز سرونٹس. یا عباد فتخون, او مائی سرونٹس فیئر می, ہیو مائی ریگارڈ. والذین اجتنبوا الطاغوت ان یعبدوها, ایز فار دوز ہو اوائڈ ورشپنگ اینی طاغوت, اینی ون ریبیلین, ریبیلنگ اگینسٹ اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی, ان یعبدوها, دے اوائڈ ورشپنگ دیم, وانابوا الی اللہ, اینڈ دے ہیو ٹرن دیئر فیسز ٹوڈز اللہ, لہم البشرا, فار دیم آر دی گلیڈ ٹائیڈنگز, فبشر عبادی. سو او محمد صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم, گیو دی گلیڈ ٹائیڈنگز ٹو مائی سرونٹس. وٹ از طاغوت؟ طغا مینس ٹو ٹرانسگریس دی لمٹ. وی سے اردو دریا طغیانی پر ہے. وٹ ڈز اٹ مین وین دی ریور از ود ان اٹس بینک, بینکس اٹس اوکے, وین اٹ اوور فلوز دی بینک, ناؤ اٹ از طغیانی. طغا اینڈ بغا, دیز ٹو ورڈز آر ویری کلوز ٹو ایچ ادر ان عربک. So this real position of all the creatures of Allah is that they have to obey Him. The sun is obeying Him, this moon is obeying Him, the galaxies are obeying Him, all the angels are obeying Him, everything is obeying Him. And for man also, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ, they have to obey. Whosoever doesn't accept total obedience of Allah, it means he has transgressed from his limits. He is Taghut. He may be your father. He may be the husband of a woman. Taghut. It will be the system. The system is of Taghut. In Pakistan, if we don't, you know, establish the sovereignty of God, although we have it written in our constitution, sovereignty belongs to Allah. But that's theoretical, not practical. Actually, it's not the case. The sovereignty of Allah is not established, it's Taghut. The whole system is Taghut. This America is the biggest Taghut of this world at this time. As Ayatollah Khomeini used to say, the biggest Satan, the largest Satan, greatest Satan on earth. That is true. So actually, whosoever crosses the limits, boundaries of obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is Tawa, and he becomes Taghut, whosoever he might be. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ, as for those who listen attentively the word of Allah, فَيَتَّبِعُونَ أَحْسَنَهُ, and then they try to follow the best of it. In our deen also there are levels, concessions for the weak. Okay, you can avail of this concession. You can avail of this concession. But for the people who have the strong will power, they must not avail of these concessions. You should try to be at the higher level of deen, not at the lower level of deen. There are levels, yes. As you know, when Abu Jahl was torturing that family of three persons, Sumayya, Yasir and Khabbab. Khabbab was the son, Sumayya mother, Ammar, yes. Ammar was the son, Yasir father, and Sumayya mother. Now this torturing, 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 in the end he got tired. He said, if you once say something which pleases me, that your God, he is also a God, okay. If only once you say this, I will let you go. Neither Sumayya agreed, she gave her life. Nor Yasir agreed, he gave her his life. But Ammar, he said, and escaped. But then he had great grief, what I have done. But then the Prophet came, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, okay, this is also permitted. To save your life, to say something by which you can save your life. But at heart, you are fully satisfied with Tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is also allowed. But this is second level. Why not to stay at the first level? When in this world you want to be foremost, higher and higher up, ہے جستجو کے خوب سے ہے خوب تر کہاں. ایوری بڈی از ٹرائی ٹو ہیو بیٹر اینڈ بیٹر اینڈ بیٹر کنڈیشن آف لیونگ. وائی ڈونٹ یو وانٹ ٹو پرسو دین آلسو ایٹ دی ہائر اینڈ ہائر اینڈ ہائر لیولس. الذین یستمعون القول فیتبعون احسنہ اولئک الذین ہداہم اللہ. دے آر دی پیپل ہوم اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ ہیز گائیڈڈ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ اینڈ دے آر دی پیپل آف انڈرسٹینڈنگ ہو ہیو دی ریئل انٹلیکٹ. اَفَمَنْ حَقَّ عَلَيْهِ كَلِمَةُ الْعَذَابِ. سو محمد ایز فار ہم آن ہوم دی چسٹائزمنٹ از جسٹلی ڈیو فَأَفَأَنْتَ تُنْقِذُ مَنْ فِي النَّارِ. ناؤ کین یو ٹیک اوے فرام دی فائر سچ اے پرسن آن ہوم the command of punishment and chastisement has come true. لَكِنِ الَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا رَبَّهُمْ. But for those who have fear of Allah, their Lord, لَهُمْ غُرَفٌ مِّن فَوْقِهَا غُرَفٌ. They will have lofty mansions. And built over them another, you know, level of lofty mansions. تَجْرِي مِن تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ. And beneath them, rivers will be flowing. وعد اللہ, دس از دی پرومس آف اللہ. لا یخلف اللہ المیعاد. اللہ ڈزنٹ گو بیک ہز ورڈز اینڈ پرومسز. الم ترى ان اللہ انزل من السماء ماء. Didn't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down water from the heaven? فسلكه ينابيع في الارض. Then he makes it penetrate the earth as springs. ثم يخرج به زرعا. And then with this water he brings forth there with crops مختلفاً الوانه whose colors are different. The crop of wheat, the crop of gram, the crop of corn, different colors. مختلفاً الوانه ثم يهيج. Then these crops, they reach their climax. فتراه مصفرا. And then they wither so that you see that their color has now changed to yellow. ثم يجعله حطاما. And then finally he makes all these things a chaff. إن في ذلك لذكرى لأولي الألباب. Verily in this is an admonishment for those people who have understanding. This is actually the simile for human life. When a son is born, you rejoice. But he is weak. But then he trains his puberty, he is strong. Then, you know, his hair turn gray and so on. Body becomes weak. Then he dies and he is buried and his body disintegrates. It becomes again clay. This cycle of human life takes 50, 60 years, 30 years. But there is the cycle. In a few months, you find the same cycle. In the botanical world, this cycle is going on, the same cycle. Then again the field is barren, nothing. Then again, you sow the seed and the rain comes, again crop, again greenery, everything. Again, when this crop has been reaped, again nothing. So this is the cycle. أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدْرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّن رَبِّهِ. Think of that person whose chest Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has opened for Islam. His chest accepts Islam totally. And he is satisfied 100% with whatever command Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given. He doesn't feel anything illogical, anything unbearable. No. In sharah, he accepts everything. فَهُوَ عَلَىٰ نُورٍ مِّن رَبِّهِ. So that he is on a light from his God. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his Lord has given him a light. As opposed to those persons, فَوَيْلٌ لِّلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُم مِّن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. There are other those people whose hearts have hardened regarding the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أُولَٰئِكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. Verily, they are in the very manifest error. اللہ نزل الحدیث احسن الحدیث کتابا متشابہا نسانیہ. اللہ has sent down, O Muhammad, on you the most excellent discourse, احسن الحدیث. کتاباً متشابہاً، اے بک ہوز پارٹس آر ریزمبلنگ ایچ ادر، اینڈ وی ہیو سین دس دی سیم سبجیکٹ کمنگ اوور اینڈ اوور اگین، ڈسکس اوور اینڈ اوور اگین ان ڈفرنٹ ورڈز، ڈفرنٹ اسٹائلس، ڈفرنٹ سیکوینسز، متشابہاً نسانیہ اینڈ ریپیٹڈ آف ریپیٹنگ تقشعر منہ جلود الذین یخشون ربہم، دی اسکنز آف دوز پیپل ہو ہیو سم فیئر آف اللہ سبحانہ و تعالیٰ شیورز ود دس قرآن وین دے ریڈ قرآن، ثم تلین جلودہم و قلوبہم اینڈ دین دیئر اسکنز اینڈ ہارٹس گیٹ سافٹنڈ فار دی ریمبرنس آف اللہ الی ذکر اللہ، ذالک ھدی اللہ یہدی من یشاء یہدی بہ من یشاء، دس از دی گائیڈنس آف اللہ. اف یو ریڈ قرآن and a shivering goes down, you know, your backbone when you read about Jahannam, about the hell, and when you know the ayat of forgiveness, Allah is Ghafoor, Allah is Sattar, Allah is Haleem, and then you have some hope in your heart, so then it means you have the light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ هُدَى اللَّهِ يَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَمَنْ يُضْلِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ هَادٍ، and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has led astray, that is, he has acknowledged his going astray. You have chosen the wrong path, okay, go. Now when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put the seal, now nobody can bring him back on the right path. أَفَمَنْ يَتَّقِي بِوَجْهِهِ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ، so the person who will have to confront the worst chastisement of the day of judgment with his face, he will have to face the fire of hell. وَقِيلَ لِلَّذِينَ ذُوقُوا وَقِيلَ لِلظَّالِمِينَ ذُوقُوا مَا كُنْتُمْ تَكْسِبُونَ، and it will be said to the evil doers, now taste what you had been earning. كَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ، those also who were before them belied. فَآتَاهُمُ الْعَذَابُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ، then the chastisement came to them from those corners from which they could never imagine. فَعَذَاقَهُمُ اللَّهُ خِزْيَ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا، so Allah made them taste the chastisement of humiliation in this world. وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَكْبَرُ، and the chastisement of the hereafter is much greater. لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ، only if they had known. وَلَقَدْ ضَرَبْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ، we have struck in this Quran all the similitudes for mankind's guidance. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ، so that they may get the admonition and the reminding. قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا غَيْرَ ذِي عِوَجٍ، and this guidance is in the form of an Arabic Quran, and there is no crookedness. The language is plain and simple, clear. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ، so that they may have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا رَجُلًا فِيهِ شُرَكَاءُ مُتَشَاكِسُونَ وَرَجُلًا سَلَمًا لِرَجُلٍ، now another simile Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has struck. There is one slave who has a number of masters, and one slave who is slave to one master. Whose condition would be better? If you are slave to two or three masters, this master is saying do this, the other says no, do this, the third one says no, do this, you will be in a fix. But if you are the slave of one master, you can please him. He will be pleased with you. You can keep him pleased with you. So one Allah, this is actually the normal life. We have to believe Allah. We have to obey Allah. Not, you know, obey Allah also and somebody else also and somebody else also. هَلْ يَسْتَوِيَانِ مَسَلَىٰ، are these two persons equal? Alhamdulillah. All praise be to Allah. بَلْ أَكْسَرُهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ، but most of them know not. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ، verily Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will have to die. وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ، in the same way, these people who are opposing you, they will also die. ثُمَّ إِنَّكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّ رَبِّكُمْ تَخْتَصِمُونَ، then on the day of resurrection, on the day of judgment, You will argue against each other before your Lord. You will say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I had conveyed to them all the message, O Allah, which you sent me. Now they are responsible. So this argument is going to be there between you and your people, your nation, on the Day of Judgment. فَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ كَذَبَ عَلَى اللَّهِ So who is a more wrongdoer than the one who forges a lie against Allah? And it means that he says, I am a Nabi, I am a prophet, why revelation is coming to me, while there is no revelation coming to him. This is the biggest lie. If somebody stands up and he says, I am a prophet, while Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not chosen him. This is the biggest lie. وَكَذَّبَ بِالصِّدْقِ إِذْ جَاءَهُ Equally wrong would be to deny and disbelieve the real prophet who has brought truth with him. So, if a prophet comes, you deny him, this is the biggest crime. But if you are not a prophet and you claim to be a prophet, this is also equal to the same. أَلَيْسَ فِي جَهَنَّمَ مَسْوًا لِلْكَافِرِينَ For all these types of disbelievers, Jahannam, hell is the abode. Now the contrary, وَالَّذِي جَاءَ بِالصِّدْقِ On the other hand, the person who brings the truth, that is, the prophet, he has brought the truth for people, for mankind. وَصَدَّقَ بِهِ And he confirms all truths. And this The Mufassirin say this denotes to Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Jaab al-Sidq Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who brought the truth for the guidance of humanity. Walladhi wa saddaqa bihi is Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. He confirmed immediately. Ulaika humul muttaqoon. These are the ones who have really fear of Allah in their hearts. Lahum ma'ishauna inda rabbihim. For them there will be everything that will lie, that they will demand. ذَلِكَ جَزَاءُ الْمُحْسِنِينَ And this is the reward of those who do good deeds. لَيُكَفِّرَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ أَسْوَأَ الَّذِي عَمِلُوا So that Allah may acquit them of the worst deeds that they might have committed. وَيَجْزِيَهُمْ أَجْرَهُمْ بِأَحْسَنِ الَّذِي كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ And then He recompenses them with their reward for the best of what they used to do. Now what is this meaning? Every good person also who is doing good deeds, but all deeds are not of one level. One virtue or one good deed is of it's good, but a lower level. Other is of a very high level. There is still a higher level of virtue. Now whosoever has become successful on the Day of Judgment, now Allah Ta'ala will ignore the lower side of his acts. And he will decide his level according to the highest deeds that he has committed. His status in Jannah, in the garden, in paradise, will be determined according to the highest good deeds that he had committed. Alaysa Allahu bikafin abdah? Is Allah not sufficient for his bondsman, his servant, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? وَيُخَبِّفُونَكَ بِالَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونَهِ O Muhammad, they are frightening you regarding those whom they call. Oh, now, you know, the curse of Hubul will come to you. The curse of Lat and Uzza will come to you. Just as the people, you know, they frightened Hazrat Ibrahim. You have declared all our gods null and void. Now their curse will befall you in the same way. وَيُخَبِّفُونَكَ بِالَّذِينَ هُمْ مِنْ دُونَهِ وَمَنْ يُذِلِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ هَادْ Whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala leads astray, decides for him that he let him go, wherever he wants to go, then there is no person who can bring him back to the right path. وَمَنْ يَهْدِ اللَّهُ فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ مُذِلْ And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided to the right path, مَا لَهُ مِنْ مُذِلْ There can be nobody who can take him to the wrong path. أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِعَزِيزٍ زِنْتِقَامٍ Is not Allah the mighty and the Lord of revenge, زِنْتِقَامٍ He takes revenge also. وَلَئِن سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ and if you ask them who created the heavens and the earth لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهُ and they will say Allah قُلْ أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَدْعُونَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ now say to them as for those deities whom you are calling upon besides Allah إِنْ أَرَادَنِي اللَّهُ بِدُرٍّ هَلْ هُنَّ كَاشِفَاتُ دُرِّهِ if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decides for me something which is painful, can these, your smother gods or goddesses, can save me? And they can relieve me of that, you know, affliction? Or, arada bi rahmatin, and if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decided for me some mercy, hal hunna mumsikatu rahmatihi, can they withhold the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When you say there is Allah, He is the greatest. There are smaller gods. Now the question is, who has the veto? The greater God or the smaller gods and goddesses? If you accept, veto is in the hand of the greater God. So now, whole the scheme collapses. What for? To worship, you know, and show respect to these smaller gods. What for? Well, the final authority is in the hand of Allah. قُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهِ Say to them, Allah is all sufficient for me. عَلَيْهِ يَتَوَكَّلُ الْمُتَوَكَّلُونَ In Him should all those who are trustful put their trust. قُلْ يَا قَوْمِ مُلُوا عَلَى مَكَانَتِكُمْ And say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O my people, strive whatever you are striving at your own places. إِنِّي عَامِلْ I am also striving for something. I am working for Allah, I am calling towards Allah, I am propagating this dawah of Allah, this call of Allah. You want to hinder it, you want to put obstacles in its way, do whatever you can do. And I am doing whatever I can do. فَسَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ Very soon you will come to know who succeeds, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives His help. مَنْ يَاتِهِ عَذَابٌ يُخْزِيهِ To whom will come the chastisement that will degrade them. وَيَهِلُّ عَلَيْهِ عَذَابٌ مُقِيمٌ On whom a lasting chastisement will remain. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ لِلنَّاسِ بِالْحَقِّ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we have sent down on you this book for people. We have sent down on you, but it is for the people, for their guidance. بالحق, with truth. فَمَنِ اهْتَدَى فَلِنَفْسِهِ Whosoever takes to the right path, gets the guidance, He gets guided for his own benefit. وَمَنْ ضَلَّ فَإِنَّمَا يُضِلُّ عَلَيْهَا Whosoever goes astray, you know, the pain will come to him. وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِوَكِيلِ And you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, are not a custodian over them. اللَّهُ يَتَوَفَّى الْأَنفُسَ حِينَ مَوْتِهَا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes the souls of the people when they die. وَالَّتِي لَمْ تَبُتْ فِي مَنَامِهَا And those who don't die in their sleep, in our sleep also, consciousness goes. We are not self-conscious. Self-consciousness, which is actually the biggest thing for us, it goes. فَيُمْسِكُ الَّتِي قَضَى عَلَيْهِ الْمَوْتِ As for those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has decreed that he has to die, he keeps the soul with him. وَيُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى إِلَىٰ عَجَلِ الْمُسَمَّى And for those who were only sleeping and the decision of death had not come for them, for their souls are returned back. يُرْسِلُ الْأُخْرَى إِلَىٰ عَجَلِ الْمُسَمَّى Till a fixed term is completed. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتِ لِقَوْمِ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ Verily in this are the signs for those people who contemplate and think. أَمِ اتَّخَذُوا مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ شُفَعَى Have they taken for themselves intercessors besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? قُلَ وَلَوْ كَانُوا لَا يَمْلِكُونَ شَيْئًا Say to them, think, maybe they don't have any power with them. وَلَا يَعْقِلُونَ And they don't understand. قُلْ لِلَّهِ الشَّفَاعَةُ جَمِيعًا Say, all intercession is with Allah. What does it mean? Allah has the authority to accept or reject. Nobody in this universe has the power to force Allah to accept any intercession. No. None. Inna shafa'ata qul lillahi shafa'atu jami'a. It is in the hands of Allah. Lahu mulku samawati wal ard. To him belongs all kingdom of the heavens and the earth. Summa ilayhi turja'un. And then towards him you will be returned. وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ. When Allah is mentioned alone with the tawheed, oneness, you find that the hearts of those people who don't believe in the hereafter, they are filled with disgust. What is saying? Tawheed? Okay. But وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الَّذِينَ مِن دُونِهِ. Now when they are mentioned, whom they love beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذَاهُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. Now they rejoice. You say something about Shaykh Abdul Qadir Jilani and Shaykh Ali Hajwari and Muinuddin Hajwari, rahimahumullah, they will be very glad. They will be listening to it. But if you begin describing the might of Allah, the exclusive obedience for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the judgment of Allah on the day of judgment, then you know they don't like it. Okay. These things are there, but not very important. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ فَاطِرَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ عَالِمَ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Say, O Allah, the originator of the heavens and the earth, the knower of the unseen and the seen, أَنْتَ تَحْكُمُ بَيْنَ عِبَادِكَ. You will judge between your servants, فِيمَا كَانُوا فِيهِ يَخْتَلِفُونَ, in all the matters in which they had been differing. وَلَوْ أَنَّ لِلَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مَا فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا. And if these evildoers possessed all the wealth of the earth, وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ, and also another like that, more, لَفْتَدَوْ بِهِ مِنْ سُوِرَ عَذَابِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, they will be ready to ransom themselves therewith from the evil of the chastisement of the day of resurrection. وَبَدَى لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يَكُونُوا يَحْتَسِبُونَ. And then there will come evidence before their eyes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what they were not expecting. They were not expecting that we will be resurrected and then we will be brought to the book and we will be required to explain our position. وَبَدَى لَهُمْ سَيِّئَاتُ مَا كَسَبُوا وَحَاقَ بِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا بِهِ يَسْتَهْزِئُونَ. And now everything will appear before them, the evils of what they had earned and that which they used to mock at. Now this will encompass them. They used to mock. What is Jahannam? What type of fire it will be? How do you say there will be a tree also there? Zakum? Absolutely nonsense. They used to mock it. But then all these things will encompass them and engulf them. فَإِذَا مَسَّلْ إِنسَانَ ضُرُّ دَعَى رَبَّهُ دَعَانَا. When an affliction touches a man, he calls upon us, prays to us. ثُمَّ إِذَا خَوَّلْنَاهُ نِعْمَةً مِنَّا. Then when we bestow upon him a blessing from us, قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ. He will say, this thing has been given to me due to my knowledge, my expertise, my intelligence. So actually I have earned these things by my knowledge. The same was the saying of Qarun, إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ عِنْدِي. I have been given this, all this wealth. So whosoever has this idea, that whatever he has earned through his intelligence, or you know, his planning, etc., etc., he is a disciple of Qarun. He is going in the way of, in the footsteps of Qarun. قَالَ إِنَّمَا أُوتِيتُهُ عَلَىٰ عِلْمٍ بَلْ هِيَ فِتْنَةٌ. No, this is a trial for you, a test for you. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But majority of them don't have the real knowledge. قَدْ قَالَهَا الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ. Those also said the same words as they are saying. Here is the reference to Qarun. فَمَا أَغْنَى عَنْهُمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. But then, when he was made to be swallowed by the earth, nothing could avail to him, could save him. فَأَصَابَهُمْ سَيِّئَاتُ مَا كَسَبُوا. Then the evils of all that they had earned befell upon you. والذین ظلموا من هؤلاء یستغیثون سیئات ما کسبوا and among these people also who are opposing you O Muhammad صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم they will also the same evil will befall upon them also وما كانوا معجزین and definitely they cannot frustrate or defeat our plans بارک اللہ لی ولکم فی القرآن العظیم ونفعنی وإیاکم بالآیات والذکر الحکیم
الله أكبر الله أكبر
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.